Popcorn Gamer Production.
Hey you guys, willkommen zurück zu Let's Play Vampire. Ich bin Sol.
Ich bin Rockstar.
Und wir spielen jetzt Doktor. Nicht wie ihr denkt, ihr Schweine.
Ja, in der letzten Folge haben wir natürlich ein Mittelchen gebraut, was wir dann wieder direkt verschwendet haben, um es wieder zu bekommen.
No. Really? Why are you here then?
I don't want to talk. My throat hurts too much.
I suppose that this pain is the reason you're here. Is someone taking care of you?
Yes. And no.
Could you at least tell me your name, sir?
Mortimer. Mortimer Goswick.
Aha. Okay, der ist das offensichtlich nicht, oder?
Do you need any help?
I'm afraid I may, sir. I don't mean to be a burden.
Medizin geben.
Ja, warte, ich will jetzt erst gucken, ob der das...
Ja, ist ja Erschöpfung da.
Ja, okay. Dann, Medizin geben.
You are not a burden, sir. Healing you is my responsibility.
And you have my gratitude for that.
Okay. Erholt sich. Sehr schön. Das dauert also einen Moment.
Alternativ könnten wir es nochmal herstellen und
How
dann den
throat,
Tom
Mr. Goswick.
Aus der Bar
so painful,
helfen.
Richtig.
I'll let you get some rest, then.
Haben Sie die geschnitten? Hast du gesehen?
Ich habe nie reingeguckt.
Ich hoffe, Sie haben die geschnitten.
Ist das?
Good evening, madam. Can I help you?
It's my son who needs you, sir.
I'm Dr. Jonathan Reed. How can I help your son?
I'm Beatrice Goswick, mother of Mortimer Goswick.
Welches mit ihr vorher sprechen sollen?
Please, Dr. Reed.
Vielleicht.
I've heard much of your talents as a physician.
What can you tell me about yourself, Mrs. Goswick?
Not much to say. Just take care of my Mortimer and I'll cover all the expenses. That's all that matters.
Are you really that rich? Most of the patients here are of a more humble origin, if I may say so.
Yes, thanks to my husband. May he rest in peace. I can cover any needed medical expenses.
May I ask if you have an occupation, Mrs. Goswick?
I'm a teacher by profession. I teach young women who are more ambitious about their futures than their families.
Okay.
What do you think of your reception here? Any complaints?
I have had the uttermost reservations about this hospital since we arrived. But we had no other choice, considering the state of emergency.
Is there something in particular that's bothering you?
Some of the staff were not especially welcoming. I suspect they're not accustomed to dealing with patients of such social standing.
Tell me more about your arrival at the Pembroke Hospital. What gave you such a bad first impression?
The ambulance driver was quite rude, for a start. And that nurse, Miss Hawkins, seems to have quite a dubious attitude.
What do you mean?
She managed to secure a bed for my son, despite the epidemic. It was a relief, but it wasn't cheap.
She charged you for a bed?
Yes. And I paid without question, considering the urgency of the situation.
I share your concern, Mrs. Goswick. Be sure that I'll talk to the people involved.
I don't expect compensation, Dr. Reed. But I'm aware such behavior would not be tolerated in other hospitals.
Okay, wir haben gerade was über die rote Pippa erfahren. Die junge Dame ist nämlich der Meinung. Okay, wir können hier nichts machen. Auf Wiedersehen.
Goodbye, Mrs. Goswick.
Die Pippa meint nämlich, sie könnte hier machen, was sie will. Da,
ach, nee, das unterbinden wir.
Ja. Ein Verräter im Krankenhaus?
Das ist doch Pippa.
Nein. Sicher, dass das...
Verlockung des Blutes. Bedenken Sie, dass das Blut von Bürgern eine größere Menge EP gewährt. Suche Bürger einer Bannstufe oder niedriger und wähle sie mit... Achso.
Mit Bedacht aus.
Okay.
Bin ich aber erstmal gegen, solange wie wir da nicht, ne?
Ja, ja.
Ich will nicht Thelma. Ich will Map haben, danke. Ja, schwierig.
Was denn, was suchst du?
Die Questmarkierung.
Da, ist doch im Krankenhaus. Ey, du bist echt blind heute.
Ja, bin ich auch.
Du musst ja auch aus der Vampirsicht raus, dann siehst du den Verräter. Und sie 8 Meter oben.
Die ist oben. Okay, da kann ich lange suchen.
Ah, der Soundtrack ist schon geil. Ja. Muss ich schon sagen.
Hat was. 20 Meter.
Geradeaus. Ach so, zu Dr. Edgar.
Ah, okay.
Swan.
Please, Jonathan, come in. Fascinating, is it not? In the last decade, so many mysteries have been brought to light with our microscopes. The human body, biology's penultimate frontier. The more we explore its boundaries, the less we're able to trace a clear line between life and death. You, my friend, have a foot in both countries. The view must be vertiginous.
It's at least as vertiginous as chatting about vampires with you, I would say.
This must be all so new to you. This area of town, the hospital, a brand new life. How stimulating it must be.
I wish I could share your enthusiasm, Dr. Swansea, but my condition defies scientific categorization. Undead? Unalive? Immortality defies logic.
I cannot express my thrill at this serendipitous turn of events. The world's most eminent specialist in blood transfusions, a vampire. One might say a gift from heaven.
There is an absurd poetry to my situation. Physician, heal thyself.
Forgive me. I've been an admirer of your work for a long time, and now you are so much more than a brilliant physician. And please, call me Edgar.
Wir sind jetzt schon auf Perdu mit dem Chefarzt. Das finde ich gut.
There is no need to apologize, Edgar. You offered me sanctuary when I had none.
Very well. I have a task for you, Jonathan. Something that will require all your newfound skills.
Please, go on.
The Pembroke only survives through the generosity of our benefactors. Unfortunately, our main donor has found herself in a bit of a bind. Now, if you could help her out...
A spokesman or politician is what you need. That's not my calling. And until I come to understand what has happened to me, I require discretion.
Discretion is in order, Jonathan. Lady Ashbury has recently received rather indelicate correspondence that, if revealed, would jeopardize her position.
And you would like me to eradicate this threat?
By the stole, of course not. I would just like you to pay her a visit. Her ladyship is certainly near the tents outside, tending the sick. You can't miss her. Look for someone impossibly delicate.
Accepted. I'll see what kind of trouble Lady Ashbury is in.
Ohne Scheiß, ne? Selbst als Arzt musst du dich hier um alles kümmern.
Sprich mit der Gönnerin des Krankenhauses.
Ich bin dabei. Wir sollten uns auch gleich mal vielleicht wieder hinlegen mit 1400 EP.
Ja, sollten wir.
The flu took my dear wife.
Ach, guck mal.
I take comfort knowing we'll soon be together again.
Mr. Rainfield, that's no way to talk. You're in good hands here, and we'll be up again soon enough. Now do me a kindness and get some sleep. I'll be back round later.
Your words are kind. The blessings of an angel. You're the sweet, sweet lady of mercy.
Good evening, Dr. Reed. It's a pleasure to see you again. You seem surprised. Dr. Swansea has brought me up to speed concerning your recent appointment to Pembroke Hospital.
You're a vamp. The lady who saved me that night, before vanishing into thin air. I remember you from the pub with Dr. Swansea.
Indeed. Allow me to introduce myself formally this time. My name is Lady Ashbury. I remember you well, in spite of the brevity of our encounter.
Offensichtlich.
So it seems our Dr. Swansea does indeed have a fascination for creatures of our constitution.
Dr. Swansea is a remarkable man. Dedicated, one might say, obstinate. He spent years compiling our bestiary.
I hope you're more disposed to answer my questions now.
You must have countless questions, but our rather urgent matter first. Swansea has explained. My cover, if you prefer, has been compromised.
Have any of the patients given you trouble?
These poor souls have so little left to live for. I do my best to ease their pain.
The world would be a better place if it were cared for by women like you.
You make me blush. I am simply a necessary evil.
Pardon my boldness, Your Ladyship, but I have questions concerning this condition we share.
As a newborn, your hunger for answers is rivaled only by your thirst for blood. But the questions need weight.
I'm a scientist. My trade is in the deciphering of mysteries, and I need information to feed my mind.
I will gladly answer every question you have, but first, prove yourself capable of resolving my predicament without eating the culprit.
Okay.
Dr. Swansea has commissioned me to be your agent in this matter. You could start by explaining what's amiss.
These past insufferable weeks, I've been the victim of extortion. I've made a first payment, but the blackmailer grows greedy. I must refuse his most recent demands.
What are your expectations? Please be precise.
As the newly appointed surgeon of this hospital, you are in an excellent position to ask innocent questions and deftly learn the identity of my blackmailer.
Uh-huh.
Who would be so foolish as to threaten you? A kindred spirit.
Even if it were the case, and I highly doubt it, a vampire would have asked for something more valuable than money. My suspicions lean toward a patient or their family.
If we're dealing with an ordinary criminal, surely you've the means to deal with it yourself, if I may.
As immortal tradition doth dictate, all fangs and hypnotic eyes ablaze. The blood would run like a river. That's what I hope to avoid. Violence has a tendency to spiral out of control.
Frag Batman, der kann auch was von sagen.
Every detail is essential. I'm your man.
My embarrassment in this matter is eclipsed only by my shame at having put the hospital at risk. The threat from our anonymous scoundrel is clear. A list of dates. My visits coinciding with the dates of suspicious patient deaths due to massive blood loss.
Ich würde sie jetzt nicht so einschätzen, sonst hätte sie den ja auch schon ausgesorgt. Würde ich sagen, ne?
I'll take care of it. Do you know where I should start?
If that was the case, I'd settle the matter myself. You could talk to our local gossip, Harriet Jones. Not a pin drops here without her hearing about it.
I'll meet that woman now.
My life, as others know, is in your hands, Dr. Reed. I'm sure of your discretion, but I do fear your powers of persuasion will be put to the test. When this is resolved, I'll be your obligé. I'll answer all questions in regards of your condition.
Okay.
Ja, dann.
Aber ist auch ein interessanter Gedankengang, ne? Wenn du wirklich sterben, also nicht sterben könntest
und unsterblich bist, ja.
Und die Ewigkeit Zeit hättest, ne? Was fängst du mit der Ewigkeit an?
Das ist es. Ja.
Klar, am Anfang hast du noch jede Menge zu tun, aber irgendwann langweilt es dich ja auch, einfach aufgrund der Wiederholung, ne?
Ja, was heißt Wiederholung? Also, das hält sich ja auch stetig im Wandel, ne?
Ja, aber dass die Zeit stetig im Wandel ist. Aber jetzt, ich sag jetzt mal, du bist begeisterter Videospieler. Ja, und fängst jetzt halt an, Videospiele zu spielen als Vampir und so weiter. Ist jetzt natürlich ein blödes Beispiel, aber ich sag jetzt einfach mal. Ab welchem Punkt würden sich Spiele inhaltlich wie spielerisch für dich so wiederholen, dass du keinen Spaß mehr daran hattest?
Ja, stimmt schon.
Dasselbe ist ja, wenn du beispielsweise Bücher lesen würdest. Irgendwann hast du alles schon mal irgendwie gelesen.
What is this? Who are you?
Alter, ohne Scheiß, die sehen alle Scheintot aus. No need for alarm, madam. Guck dir die alte an. Die liegt doch schon 3 Fuß unter der Erde.
Preposterous. Dr. Reed, you say? I don't want some bumbling intern. Where's Dr. Swansea?
Please, calm down, madam. I assure you that I am highly qualified. I'm just back from war duty.
How brave. Threatening an old defenseless woman. You know how long I've been a patient here. You've picked the wrong fight. I'm Harriet Jones.
Harriet Jones? Indeed. I've been meaning to have a chat with you. You know what goes on here better than any other patient, I gather.
Oh, better than any patient, nurse or doctor. I've seen so many vile undertakings.
I heard there have been some despicable goings on. Was there a case of blackmail?
Blackmail? Wait. You're investigating something. This isn't a social call. One of those incompetent cunts slit a poor sod's vein.
If I didn't know better, Miss Jones, I'd be inclined to say you enjoy this type of idle gossip.
God's honest truth, Doctor. It's just the way it is here. Most of these bitches would let you freeze to death before getting you a blanket.
Bitches!
You seem to know more about the goings-on here than anyone else. Beware, Miss Jones, in case suspicion should fall on you.
That's it. Blame the old and infirm. I see those little bitches' greedy little eyes. Just waiting for me to pop off, they are.
I assure you, madam, this is not an investigation into a possible medical error.
Debauchery, then? Nurses Crane, Hawkins, Brannigans, whores, all of them. They can't keep their legs shut. I've seen them scratching slutty sores.
Really? Well, if you have irrefutable proof, I'll not have the staff behaving in such a manner here.
This is your business, Doctor, not mine. But I swear one of the nurses is cavorting with some man on hospital hours.
Thank you for your time, Miss Jones. You've given me something to go on. See you on the next round.
Okay.
Pippa Hawkins, Dorothy Crane und
Doris Fletcher.
Gwenfi Brangang. Der letzte Name ist ganz komisch aussprechbar.
The patients and staff might know something.
Brannigan.
I'll start my investigation with them.
Vergiss nicht, englische Namen.
Ja.
So wie Gwendolin, sowas würde man normalerweise keinem Kind antun.
Außer man hasst sein Kind.
Ja.
Du läufst wieder raus.
Ja, will ich auch.
Warum?
Weil ich doof bin. Deshalb. Aber ich glaube, warte mal. Okay, ach, gehen wir erstmal hier rein. So, wo ist diese bubenhafte. Nee, sie ist 30 Meter. Bin ich doof? Ja genau, komm, dann machen wir es hier so. Thelma. Pippa, da ist er doch. Boah, was ist das denn? Ach so.
Unbekannt. Oh,
ja, aber der sieht sehr interessant aus. Hi. So many
deaths. Good evening, sir.
So it is true. The famous Dr. Reed has joined us. I can't think of any better news during these terrible times.
Do we know each other?
Actually, yes. We met once before, at the Rockefeller University in New York.
Dr. Tippett, yes, I remember. I was assisting Professor Carell in his research about coronary bypasses. He had nothing but praise for you.
He was also very confident about your future. And look at you now, eminent surgeon and blood transfusion specialist.
Have you heard of any underhand dealings going on in this hospital?
I have no time for such triviality, my dear colleague. We're here to save lives.
Okay, auf Wiedersehen.
Goodbye, Dr. Tippett.
Gut, dann sagen wir jetzt auch an dieser Stelle zu euch See you guys und schaltet wieder ein, wenn es weitergeht mit Let's Play Vampire.
Leute, wollt ihr kein Video mehr verpassen? Lasst ein Abo da und wenn euch das Video gefallen hat, teilen, Däumchen drunter und für alles andere sind die Kommentare below.